Most people who have chronic hypertension can be treated with a handful of drugs that have been proven to be effective. Unfortunately, some do not respond to such drugs and need alternative therapy. Without one, they are at a substantially increased risk of experiencing a heart attack or stroke. And yet, there has not been any new antihypertensive class of drugs approved in nearly 16 years. In recent years, aldosterone synthase inhibitors have emerged as a promising class of drugs for treating hypertension. Let's take a look at how these drugs work to lower high blood pressure. The renin-angiotensin aldosterone system produces the end product aldosterone. Aldosterone is a mineralocorticoid hormone that regulates blood plasma fluid and electrolyte levels. It acts on the kidneys to promote sodium and water reabsorption. This leads to an increase in blood volume, which directly increases blood pressure. The development of systemic hypertension is influenced by a higher plasma level of aldosterone. Substantial evidence indicates that aldosterone excess is very common in patients with resistant hypertension. For that reason, scientists have been looking for a drug that can be used to control the amount of aldosterone produced by the body as a way to control blood pressure. Aldosterone synthase, or CYP11B2, catalyzes the synthesis of aldosterone. Aldosterone synthase inhibitors work by binding to aldosterone synthase and preventing it from converting cortisol into aldosterone. This results in decreased aldosterone levels, which decreases sodium and water reabsorption and lowers blood pressure. The challenge with developing this class of drug is that the enzyme that makes aldosterone and the enzyme that makes cortisol are 95% identical. Developing a drug that would stop aldosterone from being made while not affecting cortisol has been difficult. There have been examples of drugs that have been developed but failed because the cortisol levels were affected. Lorundrostat is one of the aldosterone synthase inhibitors in advanced clinical development. The other is Baxdrostat. Both of these drugs have shown high selectivity for aldosterone synthase in preclinical and phase 1 studies. More importantly, the results of phase 2 clinical trials have also been promising. Both of these drugs showed significant reductions in blood pressure in people with uncontrolled hypertension. According to results from a phase 2 trial, lorundrostat lowered blood pressure significantly more than placebo in people with uncontrolled hypertension after 8 weeks. Weight appeared to impact effectiveness. Those who were more obese tended to see a bigger drop in their blood pressure. Lorundrostat was well tolerated. A small expected increase in serum potassium was observed. In a separate study, Baxdrostat at 1 mg or 2 mg daily led to a significantly greater reduction in systolic blood pressure over 12 weeks compared to placebo in adults with treatment-resistant hypertension. There were no serious adverse events related to Baxdrostat during the trial. A moderate increase in serum potassium was observed in 2 patients out of 275, none of which led to study discontinuation. However, Baxdrostat has demonstrated mixed results in phase 2 studies. In the HALO trial, it failed to beat placebo in lowering blood pressure. Some attributed this failure to hiccups in patient adherence to therapy. In conclusion, both lorundrostat and Baxdrostat hold significant promise as a novel and potentially safer treatment option for hypertension, particularly for resistant cases. Additional research is ongoing to evaluate its long-term benefits and risks and establish their position in the treatment landscape. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.